Joining us live via Skype to speak on how Nigerians are coping with COVID-19 in the U.S. is Sumina White, who is a shipping operation manager. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you very much.
How are Nigerians, in your view, taking this lockdown, especially in the U.S.?
Very seriously, in the sense that the virus has changed our day-to-day lives. All necessary precautions have been put into action. Try to advise ourselves on how best to coexist and try to keep the distance and maintain that. How would I say, maintain the distance in order to, flatten the curve. So actually Nigerians are taking it very seriously.
Do Nigerians, there like yourself, wish to come home if the government provides the needful?
I would say yes, no doubt. I would want to come back, yes.
Will you feel safer here than there? Because they have more advanced medical health care than we have here.
On that front, definitely, you know how it is. Definitely, you wouldn't compare our medical standard to that of America on that front, yeah. But, I mean, we're not, as a man that loves Nigeria, loves my country, I'm not even asking for, I'm not even asking for 100% of what America, the kind of standard of medical setup America has. If they can give us even 90 to 80%, you know, we can build up from there. You know, we really need that commitment in the part of government. You know, I've heard a whole lot of stuff when even people try to fund world-class hospitals in the likes of Abuja, where the government of that day would refuse for some personal reasons and all that, which is not very healthy. You know, really, really, Nigeria has a very welcoming environment, good weather. You can't compare it. For example, I'm in Jersey right now. It's sunny, but I can tell you it's about, let's say, in degrees about probably like 18 degrees outside, but it's sunny, right? You can't compare that to what we have in Nigeria. You know, right. We have all going for us except simple administration and lack of, goodwill, I would say, on the part of people managing the affairs of Nigeria.
I'll probably get there someday soon, but still on the situation with you and other Nigerians, are you aware of any stimulus package from the U.S. government to Africans and Nigerians?
Yes, I'd really applaud the government of the U.S. because they've really gone far and above, so to say, in the sense that personally, I've not gotten mine in the sense that mine should come in the form of check, but a bunch of my colleagues and friends have received theirs because theirs has to do with direct deposit. You know, they adopted a system where you file your tax for the last two seasons or more, and whatever information you have, they take that information to either do the direct deposit into your account and or they send you the check. The average amount, the minimum amount they are giving to individuals that qualify is 1,200, which is about 1,200. You know what that is in Naira. And for every child qualifies for 500, for each child you have qualifies for 500 and all that. You know, so yeah, it's amazing. Trust me, because a lot of people are going through a very difficult time. For me, I happen to be working right now. I'm just at a car lot of my office. I just came out to do this interview. For a lot of people that are not fortunate to work in essential organizations like mine, they are home and they don't know where the next meal is going to come from. So this stimulus check is a big one. You know, I really wish same thing can be said about dearly beloved country.
Before I let you go, what's the level of compliance that you've noticed when it comes to social distancing and people staying at home? Because we still see people go out in their cars. We still hear cases of complaints from officials that some people are not complying. Where you are, how are they managing?
Okay, from my own experience, right? Personally, I'm allowed to work, I'm allowed to drive to wherever I want to drive to officially, right? For example, most of my crew, we printed out the authority from the governor, for them to come to work and go back to work. Now, personally, I've never been pulled over by the cops to ask me where you're going, where you're coming from. But a few persons have had that experience. But all the cops are trying to do is to ensure that if you shouldn't be outside, you shouldn't be outside. But they do it with all level of professionalism. They are never going to hit you. They are never going to smack you, pull you around, or try to ridicule you. At best, they're going to give you a ticket for you to go pay some sort of fine. That is if you are found one thing. But in my own experience, everyone within our neighborhood and vicinity is keeping up with the expectations. And for example, if you go to the supermarket, right, part of the measures the government adopted is to ensure that you must wear a nose mask. I have about three in my car, and then I have my hand sanitizer, I have disinfectant and all that. For you to go into any supermarket, any of the essential stores that are open, or buy gas and all that. When I mean gas, I mean fuel or diesel, as
Right.
we call it back home. You have to wear your nose mask.
All
You
right.
possibly too will be expected to wear your hand what do you call gloves, that they know, like the plastic gloves that we use. So yeah, those are some of the measures. And also,
All right.
you keep
I'm
that
afraid, Samina, that's the much we can take. Thank you so much for your time and remain safe, please.
thank you very much. Wish you the same. Thank you for your time.